When you're first getting set up with Kajabi, you'll want to customize your system pages. And in this video, I'm going to go through your login, your library, and your 404 pages. And those may not feel like the most important things to do right away, but often that's going to be somebody's first experience of you, or your clients or students' first experience with your content after they've purchased, because everyone's going to go to the login page, everyone's going to go to the library page to then access your course or your membership. So if they get there and it isn't on brand, doesn't have your name or has irrelevant information, they're going to feel confused. It's just not a great user experience for them to have right off the bat. So I'm going to show you how to customize those three pages so that they feel on brand, they're visually appealing, they're welcoming, and it's easy to navigate for your students or your clients.
So I'm just going to open up the login page now. Actually, we'll open them all. Login, library, and 404. And these other pages, like, it comes with a system thank you page, but I just always create those. I would create a thank you page or contact page, all of these as landing pages, just because I find them so much easier to work with. So we're going to go to login, and this is what the page will look like by default. And you'll notice there are only three page sections here, header, login, and footer. On landing pages or some of your website pages, you can add additional sections, but on this one, it's pretty limited. And this looks super boring. Like, if somebody landed on this page, they wouldn't know that it was you. So you want to customize it so that the people who land here know where they are. So if you go to login and check this box next to show image, it's going to open up this logo image block up above. And I have this logo just saved from something else, but I'm going to upload a new logo just so you can see what I'm doing. And if you hover here, it says suggested dimensions, 720 by 410. So I just created in Canva this simple 720 by 410 logo. So I'm going to upload that from my downloads folder. This is Avery Davis again, fashion designer. Sometimes, I don't know, Kajabi does that, but if you just press skip, for some reason it works. I feel like this is kind of obvious. I don't know if you even need to include where it says login there, so I might just delete that. Like, obviously you need to log in. And then text submit is kind of boring. Oh, look at that. I can't wait to get started. You can see something more exciting like that. And let's put an image behind. I'm going to collapse this for a second. If you open up where it says background here, you have these options: background media type, none, image, or video. Select image, and this is Kajabi's default image. So I'm going to load a different one, this background image. I literally just looked in Canva for the word fashion, and this is one of the images that came up. So you would want to find something that kind of suits your vibe or whatever your aesthetic is. So this is, it's hard to read with the image as vibrant as it is here. What you can do is add an overlay color. So let's put some white over it. And if you just do solid white, it would be, you know, it would be all white, but we can lighten it up a little bit so that you can see that image come through, but you can still read this text here. Okay, so that's just a couple things that have made this page way better. So somebody's not going to land on your login page and have no idea where they are. They're going to land here and be like, yes, Avery Davis, this background is clearly very fashion-y, so I am in the right place. Okay, so that's your login page. And If you want to, real quick, navigate among your system pages, you can do that with this drop down here and your library page. So when you open up your library page from your list of system pages, this is what it's going to look like. It's pretty basic, the way that just the Kajabi default is. And just a few things to keep in mind. When you're logged in as an admin, you're going to see all your products here. So don't be concerned that that's what your students are seeing. They only see the products that they have access to. I'm going to show you what our page looks like now that I've customized it a little bit. This members area, I added a background image and just this text block. I spaced this text over to the right by adding a custom code block here. So we don't have to get too deep into this. Here under My Products, the term My Products doesn't always make sense. So you might change this to, you know, Learning or My Programs or something like that. And over here, Resume Course doesn't always make sense. Again, if it's a membership. So you can change that text or you can just delete it. And again, these are all the products listed. There's even more. It might go into multiple pages. Also, you have this section here for an offer storefront. And here's where you can feature other things to buy. I don't know that this makes a whole lot of sense. To me, it's a better idea to think about what you should feature inside each individual product, because most of your products or programs are going to have, you know, one or two things that just naturally complement them. This library page is going to look the same to everyone. So I would probably remove the offer storefront section of your page unless all your stuff like works together. And next we're going to update the 404 page, which it picked up on those changes. So we're going to reload this page. So a 404 page, if you don't know, is if you've got like a dead link, if the URL like doesn't work anymore, this is where people are going to be directed to. So you can update the text in here. You can make this sound more fun. Whoops. And again, image. Maybe I'll just use that same image. You can go to select a recent file and we'll just use that same image that we used on the login page, just to make it feel a little bit more on brand. Yeah, same thing. Let's add some white to it. And actually under desktop layout, I'm going to squeeze this up a little bit because it's a lot of space above that box. Okay. Add up a little bit. So, and then this button action, it defaults to sending them back to home. So if we preview this page, previewed it here, and then if we click this, it'll take them back to the homepage for this account. But you can change that if you want to send them to a landing page or anywhere else. You can change that in here.
Okay, so now these system pages are customized and on brand. And I think that you can tell with just a few images, changing the graphics and some fonts, it's going to look just a lot prettier and it's going to feel on brand. It's going to be a better experience for your users. So thank you so much for watching and I will see you next time.